Blood Rain is a game series starting with a 2002 hack-and-slash game, centering around a Dampir, aptly named Rain, who tries to help rid the world of evil supernatural forces. But Soapy, what is a Dampir, you may ask? Well, dear viewer, a Dampir is a half-vampire, half-human hybrid, like Wesley Snipes. I've actually played the original Blood Rain less than I probably should have as a vampire nerd, but I get the gist of it and do plan on checking the games out more in the future. But that leads me on to today's topic, a film adaptation which serves as a prequel to the first game. You know who directed it? Uwe Boll. Much like the subjects of some of my previous reviews, Boll gets a pretty bad rep, especially when it comes to his video game adaptations, the most infamous of which being his adaptation of House of the Dead. Side rant, but why don't people remake these movies? They're begging to be remade! Anyways, I have actually discussed Uwe Boll on my channel before, when I reviewed the movie Heckler, which featured a segment about Boll's Raging Boll persona. It is pretty infamous, but for those who are unaware, the guy literally boxed online critics in a boxing ring. Enough said. Before I get into my commentary segment, I just want to let everyone know that I have an important channel update at the end of the video, so if you'd be interested in that, please stick around. So, let's talk about Blood Rain. Without further ado, on with the review. The film opens with three members of the Brimstone Society, Vladimir, Katerin, and Sebastian, who get a tip from a bartender about Rain's existence. Michelle Rodriguez is the only one I recognize out of these three. We also get our first on-screen vampire killing here, when Sebastian notices that one of the customers does not have a reflection. Everyone's surprisingly casual about it.
I like you, Brimstone people. You never make a mess of the place.
I don't know if this is because this is just a bad movie, or everyone is so used to seeing this kind of thing that it's just not shocking anymore. Rain has been kept prisoner in a circus, and she is given a crucifix by her friend who wants to escape the circus with her. The vampire rules in this movie aren't super clear, I'll elaborate in a bit. Rain does manage to escape from the circus one night, and she bites and fights off a bunch of the circus workers that try to stop her, and the blood is really excessive and cartoony. I don't think that this is inherently bad, it's just something that I noticed. In some of the flattest dialogue ever, the Brimstone gang explain the conflict of the film to us.
Kagan is building an army of thralls, and we're on our way to a carnival. Am I the only one who thinks this is madness?
It doesn't really sound like this is an urgent matter from the delivery, and direct exposition is a really lazy way of getting the message across to the audience. Couldn't they show us this Kagan, King of the Vampires, building his army, Lord of the Rings style? They find the remains of the circus, and take care of the bodies that were drained, but they also find Rain's friend from earlier with a bite mark. Rain apparently went full creature mode and bit her friend. Kinda twatty, right? She was trying to help you, monster mode or not, and now the monster police have to kill her. So rude, some friend Rain is. Billy Zane then appears as some aristocratic guy who is in cahoots with Kagan. He is also meant to be Michelle Rodriguez's dad. Don't these two only have like a decade-wide age gap? Also, I'm sorry, but what is that wig? He looks awful! That night, Rain finds a family getting ambushed by vampires, and saves them. At least cover the child's eyes or tell her to hide, she's had enough frightening for a lifetime. At a campsite, she bites another vampiress, and I'm like, can you do that? News to me, I guess. She goes to a fortune teller who confirms some horrible details about her life that she's implied to have already suspected through dreams and visions and stuff. You know, the usual. Long story short, Kagan is her dad, he killed her mum, Rain wants to kill him. In contrast, Kagan is looking for Rain, perhaps for some kind of family reunion. The lady tells her that Kagan is after a talisman called the Eye, and that she should get it if she wants an audience with him. Ooh, the Eye, spooky. I like that a cat ended up in this shot though, very cute. Rain sneaks into a monastery where the Eye is hidden, but this big monk guy is guarding it. She does some cool backflips and mashes him up with a spiked club. Brutal! In the talisman's room, Rain has to get past these horrible CGI spike things. When she does manage to get to the box holding the talisman, the room starts filling with water, which burns Rain, but she is able to hang off the ceiling. She absorbs the talisman in some way by looking into it, and once she does so, she is immune to the water. Okay, in this film, Dampirs are immune to crucifixes and sunlight, and can heal by drinking blood, but are burned by water. One could assume that this is holy water, but the circus used some in a demonstration, and I don't know how they'd have easy access to it. And they just call it water. I don't get it. One of the other monks explains to Rain that centuries ago, some vampire guy called Belial discovered how to become immune to water, the cross, and sunlight. Obviously, he was defeated, and his parts were scattered, and you can assume that Rain absorbed his eye. Kinda yucky. You can also assume that Kagan wants all of the pieces. The monastery is raided by Kagan's human slaves, and Rain is captured and taken to the home of Leonid, who is played by... Meatloaf? Come on, man, you're too good for this movie! And again, with that awful wig! The monster police show up and raid the place, shattering all the windows around Leonid. He dies in an effect that would be good for a video game at the time that this film came out. Thank goodness Meatloaf's appearance was cut short. With Kagan still pursuing Rain, the monster police take her to their headquarters, although she is kept in a cell.
I do not thirst for human blood. If you have live animals here, rats even, I will regain my strength quickly and be on my way.
I don't trust her.
Then what was all that blood rage shite about in the beginning? Why did you bite your friend? For a laugh or what? This makes no sense. Clearly she's a liar, so I wouldn't trust her either. Despite this, Rain and Sebastian have an emo off, and it's pretty cringe. Apathetic acting and all.
What do you know of pain? My father's Kagan. My mother was killed before my own eyes.
My mother and father were both killed by Vladimir. They had turned, and I was to be slaughtered.
Michelle Rodriguez and Rain have a frenemy moment where they practice dueling together, and she later advises Vladimir not to travel with Rain, as she considers her a liability. Ironically, she ends up betraying Vladimir and looking for Belial's heart herself inside her grandfather's caves. Rain tries to stop her, ends up killing her, and takes the heart for herself. Vladimir, Sebastian, and Rain are apprehended in Kagan's castle, and Rain lies to the other two about what became of their friend. Just tell them that she betrayed them to help her father. It's plausible and the truth. Kagan begins a ritual to extract the eye from Rain, but Vladimir and Sebastian escape prison and interrupt, only for both of them to end up mortally wounded. Thankfully, the box Kagan took from Rain was empty, and Sebastian manages to shoot Kagan with his crossbow, with Rain delivering the finishing blow. Sebastian refuses Rain's offer to save him by turning him into a vampire, and the movie ends with a zoomed-in shot of Rain sitting on her father's throne. How artistic. This movie was pretty much doomed from the start. According to a 2011 interview by Engadget with its screenwriter, Guinevere Turner, she turned in the first draft of her script 2 weeks late. This made Boll very angry, and he just decided to put what she called 20% of what she wrote into production. She doesn't seem to approve of the final product much at all either. The practical effects are forgivable, but the CGI in this movie is just unbelievable. I don't believe that those spinning blades are actually there, and this movie isn't quite goofy enough for me to just go along with it. And the wigs, were they even trying? They just looked so bad. I doubt they even brushed them beforehand. Some of the editing in the beginning of the film is very bizarre too. There's a scene where Rain is having a nightmare, I think, and she's in this weird jungle setting. It took me a moment to even figure out what was going on. The sequence is just edited so jarringly. This next point may be nitpicking, but it did bother me personally. The way that they say Dampir in this movie isn't like any other way I've heard it be pronounced.
There was an incident of blood rage at the Sherban Carnival. A Dampir.
A journey, perhaps, to within? Dampir.
On the Wikipedia article for the topic, the IPA transcription reads as Vampir, and I found a channel with the help video for saying it in English.
Dampir.
It comes across like the actors in the film are misreading the word. Is there a reason why they're pronouncing it differently? The reception to this movie wasn't too great either. It has a solid 3.0 on IMDb, and is listed on the Rotten Tomatoes 100 Worst Movies of All Time page. Not a great look. Personally, I don't think that this is a horrible movie. It's bad, and I think it's lazy. The fact that it's apparently based on a fifth of a first draft script kind of says it all, but I've seen worse. Now, to discuss my channel update. I'm going to be making some changes to my upload schedule to suit some changes in my personal schedule. I will be making videos, they will just be out less frequently than they have been, and I hope that's okay. Thank you all for being patient, and I hope you all enjoy the content that's to come. Well, that's all for this video. Be sure to follow me on social media as they are all linked to my description box. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and as always, thanks for watching.
The blue and green ones are my favorite kind, but I'll eat the colored ones from time to time. 'Cause Polos is life, 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 Polos is life. Sleep all night and then